Hey everyone, how's it going? I'm Sam from Smart ICU Investor. Today I want to talk again about some crazy token metrics. So yesterday Dfinity came out with their token structure, and it's interesting to say the least. The specifics are that they sold 25% a year ago in February, I will say that. So ETH was much lower back then. Let's just say 10x based on last year's returns. And then they did another sale, a private sale where they sold around 4%. And then in the public sale, they're going to sell around 10% for the public sale. But so that's not really the issue. The issue is the difference in prices between everything. So the seed round gets 200x just for coming in from last year, which is crazy already. The private round gets 3x, and then if you're in the public round, you get shafted. Plain and simple. And then the team keeps 50% as well too. I mean, I don't know where these crazy token structures come from and who keeps on designing these things, but it's just all a mess. Something's going to have to happen where, you know, a good majority of these investors are going to have to get wiped out to show that these big raises are not, they're not good, and they don't achieve long-term success for at least from the investor side. I mean, investor side, we want small market cap moving forward. And then also, this also goes for Hashgraph as well too, who's going to do a $200 million sale for 5% of the tokens, which is just crazy as well too. I would say that I don't really know how their mining system is going to work. I mean, it's a DAG, so everything should be pre-mined, I guess. I'm not 100% sure on that. I haven't read the white paper yet, but I pretty much assume that all the DAGs are already mined. That is it's a different system. It's not a blockchain, so the tokens don't need to be mined. In that sense. So yeah, it's interesting to see companies starting to get pretty crazy in their valuations. I think this will continue. You know, we haven't gotten into any of the major companies. I mean, Telegram's the biggest company to come out and have their ICO so far, but really haven't had any S&P 500, 100 companies come out and say they're going to have an ICO. I think there's probably a lot of regulatory hesitancy based on regulatory requirements and what a ICO would mean for a Fortune 500 company and if there would be any liability towards the shareholders. So we're going to get there. I mean, eventually you'll have all of the biggest companies. I'm sure there'll be Apple Coin, or maybe Apple doesn't. Maybe Apple just integrates the coins into their system and then becomes the provider of transactions for them. But I don't think we're there yet. You know, who's to say that Microsoft isn't going to do their own one? But if they did, you know, how many billions would that be worth? Or would it even gain any interest at all? I mean, we've developed the base, which is Bitcoin, Ethereum, and then the other ones. But, you know, how many other specific tokens do we need? You know, if it was a Microsoft token, it would have to exist specifically within a Microsoft system. Or would they just use Ethereum or Bitcoin or something? I mean, I see the maximalist argument in saying that everything can be done in Bitcoin. There is no need for shitcoins. because they don't have value, and you could really just have different variations of Bitcoin, which then allow for, you know, one coin to rule them all, right? I think it's natural in a healthy competitive market to have alternatives to the majors. You know, they provide new technology, new competition, all new sorts of things which they can bring to the table. And so I don't think it's a bad thing that we have, you know, 1500 cryptocurrencies at the moment. I mean, most of them are tokens. And when we talk about like pure infrastructure, there's not, maybe it's like what, 200 coins. And a lot of them are like variations or just clones of another coin. So really let's, you know, look to the top 100. And yeah, so, But the token mechanics and token structure really takes it away and makes it undemocratic, and it really puts the power of back into the business holders, back into the ownership, rather than decentralizing that power. I mean, one of the biggest things that that Bitcoin has going for it is the is in their distribution, right? You have banks, you have private citizens, you have hedge funds, you have sovereign wealth funds all around the world who own Bitcoin. And so it has a vast, protective effect on the currency itself. So when you look at something like Ripple, which is not a cryptocurrency, it's just a token that they control 60% of, it's really worrying because, who's to say that they're gonna dump the coin or use it for their own good or use it for their own benefit. I mean, you can't really say when someone controls 60% of an entire token. So this is just my thoughts. I'm a little bit wary. I wish I would have been able to. Maybe it's a little bit of FOMO of not being able to get into that early seed round. But who knows? I think we're moving into a new space, and it'll be interesting to see how these bigger projects play out in the next few months. I'm very excited for it. If you have anything that you want me to review, just leave a message below. Make sure to like and subscribe, and we'll be back soon.